Welcome class to another unit, and we are going to cover the world of the Aztecs. And most people know about the Aztecs because there's so many connections that Mexicanos have with the Aztecs. The simple fact that Mexico goes by the name of Mexico because the Nahua tribe that settled in the valley of Anahuac, or the valley of Mexico, were the Mexicas. That's how Mexico had been given is named after the Mexica tribe. But also, most of you have seen the Mexican flag, and in the center of it, you see the myth of Aztlan. And it's kind of nice because you have in the middle of it the emblem of an eagle landing on top of a cacti, and that was the Aztec prophecy. According to the god of war, which Huitzilopochtli was going to tell the Aztecs to settle once they see an eagle landing on top of a cacti, and that's what you see embedded in the Mexican flag. There's so many other things that are connected to the Aztecs, believe it or not, La Virgen de Guadalupe, because for many natives, Guadalupe was Tonantzin, and that was Mother Earth. Then later she becomes La Madre de Mexico, the mother of the indigenous people of Mexico. Another cool connection is the myth of Aztlan. The Aztecs migrated from a cave called Chicomostoc. It took them hundreds of years till they got to the Valley of Mexico, but then Chicanos took the myth of Aztlan in the 60s to reaffirm the fact that they were indigenous from the southwest. And there's so much about the Aztecs that I'm not going to get to cover, but we are going to only get an introduction and sort of the most important things about the world of the Aztecs. Are the Aztec guns? No, they're not. Nahua or Nahuatl people continue to retain its culture. Most of it is around Mexico City. That was the Valley of Mexico, continues to be the Valley of Mexico. And that's all for this week. We're going to concentrate in the world of the Aztecs, and also the arrival of Hernan Cortes, who destroyed the Aztec Empire. I'm looking forward to your responses throughout this week, and that's all for now.